Welcome to my new video class, and today we are making summer shorts. This project is very easy to make. This project will not require any patterns, so if you are new to pattern making, please welcome, let's make it together. This short will not have side seams. They will have literally just two seams. It's a crotch seam and small inner seams. So it will be literally 1 hour project. You will need about 15 inches of fabric. I will use knit fabric. It's a cotton and polyester blend. Also, you will need a measuring tape. You will need your ruler and your marker, like textile marker or special chunk. And of course, you will need pins. So let's begin. So when you decide where the level of the waist will be on your shorts, you need to take a measurement of hip circumference. And after, you need to measure the length of the crotch seam from the center of the front to the center of the back. And then you need to measure how long you want to make your shorts. I will make them 11 inches long. Then you need to fold your fabric a half, edge to edge. If your fabric has print, make sure that the prints are matching on both sides. And then we need to divide our folded fabric by half, make marks, and draw a vertical line through these marks, dividing visually our fabric into two similar rectangles. And this line will be instead of our side seam. Then I will take my hip circumference measurement. I will add 1 inch of easy. If you want to make it more form-fitted, then don't add any easy. So for me it was 42 inches. And I divide this distance by 4. And then I will make marks by this 10.5 inch on each side of this vertical line that we previously drawn. I will also draw a horizontal line through folded fabric to even all uneven edges. And then from this line, I will mark 1.5 inch marks for the one piece cut facing or edging, which we will use to pull elastic through it. And I will also draw a line through these new marks. And this new line will indicate the waist line of our shorts. And from this new line, we will mark the length of our shorts, which is for me 11 inches. And I will also mark them on the sides and draw another line through these new marks. And then we will repeat the top marks, which is 10.5 inches from the center line on each side. We'll repeat them on the bottom line. So 10.5 inches we will mark on each side from the vertical center line. And then we will draw vertical lines connecting bottom and top marks on each side. And now we will need to form crotch lines and top line. So first we will need to lower the waistline on the center of the front detail in 1 inch. And then we will gradually connect this mark with the center of the back detail. Then on this new line we will mark 1 inch away from the center line on the front and 1.5 inch away from the center line on the back. Now we will need to mark the distance to the crotch line, and if normally I would mark 9.5, 10 inches, but in my case I will mark 7.5 inches, since the top of my shorts will be lower than my actual waistline on the body. So now we can form the crotch line curve on this level, but before we need to make the same measurement on the front detail. So the crotch seam on the back need to be about a half of the entire crotch measurement. And to mark the end of the crotch area, we need to take our 10.5 inches, which is 1/4 of the entire hip circumference, divided by 3, and mark this measurement, which is 3.5 for me, on this horizontal line. So we take this measurement, divide it by 3, and mark it over here. And we will repeat the same with the front panel. So we mark 3.5 inches from the center of the front panel. And then we need smoothly connect these two marks. I would also suggest you to lower the center of the crotch seam in the back. So as you can see over here, go a little bit lower than the horizontal line and connect it. And also I will draw a curved line connecting the end of the crotch with the bottom line. And forming a crotch line on the front panel, you need to draw it with little deeper curve than in a back panel. So now we can already cut our details and stitch it, but I also want to show you what else you can do optionally. So if the width of the fabric allows you, you can make the crotch seam of the back panel a little bit longer and crotch seam of the front panel a little bit shorter. For this you can see, as my fabric allows you, I will make a 1/2 inch it longer, and on the front panel I will be making it 1/2 inch shorter. So I will subtract it from the front and add it to the back. This way our pattern will have more classic look. Also, I will make the inner seam even more curved. So in this way, my shorts will be more form-fitted at the bottom. If you want to make your shorts more loose at the bottom, just leave this line how it is. And another adjustment that you can make the bottom line of the front panel a little bit shorter in the middle and curved between inner and side seam. Especially it will be looking very good on short and the form-fitted shorts. Now we need to add 1 1/4 inch allowance for hemming. And now we can cut it. And also while cutting a crotch seam, I will not leave any allowances because I'm using knit fabric and I want it to be more form fitted. But definitely if you want to make it from different type of fabric, leave allowances. We also need to make the cutting line of the waistline of the front panel 1 inch lower, because if you lower it, the waistline on the front and the cutting line also will be lower for 1 inch now. So now we can fold each half of our shorts and we will stitch the inner seam on each half. For these seams I will use my serger with 4 threads and 2 needles. And for my fabric I will use black and white threads for needles and black and white threads for loopers. Then we need to iron the seams. Now I will a little bit adjust the crotch seam in the center, cutting off the sticking part near the inner seam. So for this I will fold these inner seams together and smoothly cut it off. And then I can stitch the crotch seam connecting the both parts of shorts together. So I will show you how I fold them together. I put the one half with the crotch seam facing up, I fold the second half in the same way and put it with the crotch seam facing down. Then I peel back one layer, I connected the inner seams together, and then I connected two crotch seams of the front panels and two crotch seams of the back panels. And then I will overlock the top edge and the bottom edges of the each leg. And now we need to overlock bottoms of the legs. And then I will iron stitched seams and overlocked edges to make them flat. And now I will use gauge to fold and iron even distance for top line and for hemming. So I will set up the gauge for 1.5 inches to iron the top line, and for 1.25 inches to iron a hemming line. And I would also suggest you to pin foldings after ironing before stitching. Now I can stitch them around, and in the waistline I will stitch two seams, one in just in the top of the overlock and one is in the between of the folding edge and overlock. I will stitch these seams with a zigzag stitching, medium size of zigzag, and also I will replace my regular needle with a jersey, or you can use also stretch needles. And on the waistline, I will leave distance between beginning and the end of the each seam. In this way, I will have a distance to pull elastic through. So this is, will be our entrance for the elastic as a distance between beginning and the end of the stitching. And for the hemming, I will stitch just one seam on each leg, right on the top of the overlock seam. Now we will need to iron our seams to take away all this waviness. We need to set up our iron on steam position and on cotton temperature. And use an extra steam button also. And now, when all our seams are flat, we can pull elastic through. For that, we need to stretch our elastic around our body and the level where the top of the shorts will be located, mark it, and cut two pieces of the same size. And then we will use a safety pin to pull elastic through. And first we will pull it through the top coulisse and then from the second lower coulisse or channel. When you pull it already and fold it for stitching, make sure that the elastic is not twisted in the middle. And now we will pull elastic through the lower channel. And congratulations, your new summer shorts are ready. My dears, I hope you like this project, I hope you learned something new from this project, and as always, I'm looking forward to see your comments, how your shorts came out, and wish you good luck, and looking forward to seeing you in my next video. Bye-bye!